it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to share some hairstyles using Dutch braids. So let me know in the comments section which of the three hairstyles is your favorite. And let's get started. I'm going to be doing two Dutch braids along the top of my head. Since I want them to be about the same size, I'm going to have my part slightly off center. I just prefer this over a direct center part. So starting on the right side, I'm going to pick up a small section of hair to use for my braid. And I am leaving out some hair to frame my face. This section is next to the part line, about an inch or so back from the hairline, and I'm going to divide it into three smaller pieces. And since I'm doing a Dutch braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands under the middle strand. And as I go, I'm also going to be incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. I'm only going to bring in about three sections on both sides of the braid. One side from right along the part line and the other side from directly under the braid. I want to leave out most of the hair on the sides of my head because I'll be using that hair later on for a different part of the hairstyle. So once I've brought in my sections, I'm going to stop adding in additional pieces and just braid the section a little further down. Then I'm going to go back over the braid and carefully pull on the sides so the braid is wider and looks bigger. Then I'm just going to slide a couple bobby pins over the bottom so it doesn't come loose. Now I'm going to repeat the same steps with the hair on the left side of my part line. So I'm picking up a section about an inch or two back from the hairline, and I'm going to braid a Dutch braid along the top of my head next to the part. So I'm just crossing the side strands under the middle strand, and as I go, I'm also going to be incorporating new sections of hair into the braid, and I'm going to be bringing in about three or four sections. One side from right along the part line and the other side from directly under the braid. I want to leave out most of the hair on the sides of my head, working my way along the top of my head. And then I'm just going to braid the hair down a little ways without adding in any additional pieces. And then I'm just going to go back over the sides and pull on them carefully to make the braid wider. And then of course, slide a bobby pin over the bottom of the braid so it doesn't unravel. Now that the two braids are done, I'm going to pin them against my head. So I'm going to lay the right braid over the left and pin the braids in place. I like to slide my bobby pins into the middle of the braid, grabbing only a few hairs with each bobby pin, and then slide them upwards along the braid so they're hidden underneath the hair. A good rule of thumb is to pin wherever you're holding the braids, and I just keep pinning until they feel nice and secure and aren't going to fall loose. So once that's done, I'm going to remove the bobby pins that were at the ends of the braids and then unravel them up to where they're pinned. So now I'm going to divide off a small section of hair on the right side of my head next to the braid, and I'm going to twist this section upwards and then add in a couple more pieces of hair as I twist it towards the back of my head. I'm going to go back over the twist and pull on a few pieces so the twist is fuller. This will help make the twists look bigger, and it will also help hide any part lines that are underneath the twist. And then I'm just going to lay it over the braids and pin it on the left side. Then I'm going to take a similar sized section on the left side of my head, twist it upwards, and add in some additional hair as I twist it back towards the back of my head. And then to make the twists bigger, I'm going to carefully pull on the edges, of course. And then I'm going to lay it underneath the first twist and pin it on the right side. So I'm just sliding a bobby pin into the twist so the hair stays in place, but the bobby pin will be hidden underneath the hair. And now I'm going to divide off a small section of hair underneath the braids and twists, and I'm going to use this to create a topsy tail. So I'm going to wrap a clear elastic band over the section, and then I'm going to create a gap in the hair above the elastic and flip the hair around the elastic band to create two twisted side sections. Then I'm going to gently pull on small pieces of the twists so they're 2 to 3 times bigger. I pull on the sides as well as in the center of the twists. I literally pull the hair back out of the elastic, so don't be afraid to pull the hair a lot. If it becomes too much or gets too big, you can always take the elastic out and redo it again. It won't unravel the whole hairstyle if you have to do that. So once I like the way that it looks, I'm going to wrap a section of hair around the elastic band. So I'm just going to divide off a small section of hair and wrap it around the elastic band about 3 times.
And then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the wrapped hair so the elastic is going into the bobby pin. And this will hold the wrapped hair in place while hiding the elastic band at the same time. For this hairstyle, I'm going to part my hair into two sections. I'm creating a zigzag part line down the back of my head. Doing this will help hide the actual part line instead of just doing a straight line. So then I'm just going to clip away the hair on the right side to start with the hair on the left. And I'm going to leave out some hair to frame my face. Pick up a piece to begin my braid, and I'm splitting this into three sections. And since I'm doing a Dutch braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands under the middle strand. So as I braid, I'm also incorporating new sections of hair into the braid, and I want to add in all of the hair from the left side of my head. So I'm just trailing the braid around the left side, incorporating new pieces as I go, and I'm bringing them into both sides of the braid. And then once the braid reaches the back of my head and I've brought in all of the hair from this side, I'm just going to continue braiding this section all the way down to the ends and then slide a bobby pin over the bottom. Now I'm going to let down the hair on the right side and repeat the same steps, creating another Dutch braid. So I'm leaving out some hair to frame my face again, and I'm going to pick up a section near the part and divide it into three pieces. Again, I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand, and I'm going to be incorporating new sections into the braid on both sides. This braid is going to sit above the other braid, so I want to make sure to keep it a little bit higher on my head so they can easily overlap once I pin them. After all of the hair from this right side is brought into the braid, I'm just going to continue braiding the section down to the ends, and then again slide a bobby pin over the bottom so it doesn't unravel. And now I'm going to take both braids and wrap them around to the front of my head. And I'm going to kind of pinch and pull on different pieces of the braid just so it's soft and I like the way they come together. And then I'm just going to use the bobby pins from the ends of the braids to pin the hair in place. I didn't want to braid the hair all the way to the bottom just because the braids get so skinny and small. So I actually just kind of twist the hair, and you just want to make sure to hide the bobby pins as best you can just so that they don't show. I like to slide them into the hair but then under the braid, and then that really helps hide them. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to divide my hair into two sections. So I'm going to create a zigzag part line down the back of my head. A zigzag line will help hide the actual part line, so I tend to always do this for these types of hairstyles. So then I'm going to tie off the right side so I can braid the left side first. And I'm creating another Dutch braid for this style. So I'm going to pick up a section of hair near the hairline and divide it into three equal pieces. I'm going to begin the braid by crossing the side strands under the middle strand and alternate between the left and right side strands. Then after the initial stitch of the braid, I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. And I want to add in all of the hair from this side of my head for this particular style. So I'm going to continue the braid, crossing the side strands under the middle strand while bringing in new sections of hair, working my way down this left side of my head. So I'm crossing the side strand under the middle, picking up a new section of hair from my head and bringing it into the braid. And then I'm going to cross the side strand on the other side under the middle, pick up a new section of hair from this side and bring it into the braid as well. And I'm just working the braid along the top portion of my head. And once the braid reaches the nape of my neck and I've brought in all of the hair, I'm going to use a clear elastic band to tie off the end of the braid. And now I'm going to repeat the same steps as before and create another Dutch braid with the hair on the right side of my head. So I'm picking up a section of hair near the hairline and dividing it into three smaller pieces. I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand, and I'm going to be incorporating new sections of hair into the braid as I go like before. So I'm working my way down the right side of my head, bringing in new sections from along both the hairline and from along the middle part, until the braid reaches the nape of my neck. So I'm crossing the side strand under the middle, picking up a new section of hair from my head and bringing it into the braid. And then I'm going to cross the side strand on the other side under the middle, pick up a new section of hair from this side and bringing it into the braid. And then I'm going to cross the side strand on the other side under the middle, pick up a new section of hair from this side and bring it into the braid as well. And I'm just working the braid along the top portion of my head. And once the braid reaches the nape of my neck and I've brought in all of the hair, I'm going to take another clear elastic band and tie off the end of the braid like before. And now with both braids done, I can go back over each one and carefully pull on the sides so the braids look wider and more full. You can really pull out the braids a lot and make them extra big, or just pull them out a little bit so they're only slightly larger. I like them to look really big for pictures, but kind of somewhere in between for actual daily wear. But then as a finishing step, I'm just going to divide off small sections of hair from each ponytail and wrap them around the elastic bands individually to hide them, and then just hold each section in place with a bobby pin.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to let me know in the comments which of the hairstyles was your favorite. Be sure to like and subscribe as well so you never miss any future videos, and I will see you next time.